2-2 at the Milwaukee Mile this year. Congratulations.
Well, we've won a lot of races here in the past, but we've also lost a lot of races in the past. So I'm really happy because this is a new car and we're trying to sort it out and we ain't really that ready. So I think this is great that we won this race for my team, my family. We've all been working so hard to try to get to where we need to be. And, you know, for my sponsors, Coors Light and Goodyear and Chevrolet, too, you know, this is great to win the race. And it's in front of my, more or less, I say hometown because it's Wisconsin, right. And I'm a Wisconsin native. And Milwaukee's such a great town for races and racing the fraternity, whether it's the crowd, whether it's the racers, whether it's the people. And when you come to Milwaukee racing, it's time to go racing.
What about this Skoll Racing Classic? It's first try here at the Milwaukee Mile. What did you think about it?
Well, I think hopefully they'll carry this on because it gets three racing groups together, and the fans get to see an assortment of racing all in one day. And of course, the Milwaukee Mile is a place to have it. And realize, you know, I think this thing could annually build up to be a happening. You know, this is the first one. You know, it turned out fair and everything's fine. But like this thing by the second, third, fourth, fifth annual, I got to believe that this would be the place to be.
You took the lead on lap 10 of this race, and you just kind of widened up the lead to about a quarter mile. What made you all of a sudden go that fast and that far out in front?
Well, I wasn't running the car that well. I did kind of turn up the wick getting through there because I had to start 14 because they inverted the field, you know. And I kind of turned the wick to get through there because they're paying lap money. And, you know, when they pay lap money, that means if you lead, you're making money every time you turn in a circle, you know. And I thought, if I'm going to get on up there, I might as well get on up there a little quicker. And once I got up there, I just kind of, I didn't run hard. I think the reason that I got such a big lead is the other fast guys that got inverted took them longer to get through. And so, really, I just had a cushion there. And I knew it was going to get closed up by yellow, so I wasn't running that hard. But I just got through the pack quicker than anybody else. You know, I've been considered a pretty good traffic driver. And if you watch real close, you can see why.
Did the traffic at the end bother you? It seemed to get bunched up, and then you were almost in an accident on the second to last lap. That caused problems?
Well, I had to win this race twice. You know, the yellow come out with one lap to go, and the guy that spun right in front of me.